Now, to officially welcome you to Kennesaw, I want to introduce our president, Sam Olens. Sam, as many of you know, is a longtime supporter of transparency in government, dating back to his days as chairman of the Cobb County Commission and as attorney general for the state of Georgia. And in fact, the Georgia First Amendment Foundation has granted him a few years ago our highest honor, the Welner Freedom of Information Award, for his work on Georgia's open records and open meetings law. So we're happy to have you here.
Thank you. So it's a pleasure to be here. Do you have me in the right focus, Nydia?
You're perfect.
Okay.
Thank you, President.
You can make me tall, thin. Go for it. So it's a pleasure to be here. It's a pleasure to have you at KSU. See, of course, Commissioner Brown, Commissioner Cupid. Years ago, I actually was invited to the ACCG, Association County Commissioners of Georgia last life. And I was supposed to do a little talk to the incoming commissioners, the newbies. And first thing I knew, I walked in the building. It was at the Continuing Ed Center at UGA. And someone said, it's the other sheriff. And I said, excuse me? And they said, well, you're acting like you're a sheriff. And I go, well, I had the two phones, but I didn't have the gun. And they said, well, you keep giving grief to local elected officials, and we thought you were one of us because you were a local elected official. And the answer is follow the law. It's not you used to be a local elected official, so now leave them alone. You don't leave anyone alone. You follow the law. You don't protect the winners and losers. And then I literally, as a result of that, totally changed my talk, which is, this is all about how you demonstrate maturity. The voters approved your selection. It doesn't mean you know the answers to any questions. It means you fooled them. You won. Now you have to show maturity and be worthy of their vote. So I told them all type things like, you know, the whole adage, the old adage, what would your mother say? And before you take a vote, before you do something, think about it. It's all about leaving with the same integrity that you came into office with. So I've enjoyed working with the college here, the Humanities College, the School of Communications. I think it's really important, the programs. The funniest thing I had, I think, with this school when I was AG is they had one of the students that annual process to see whether folks actually will respond in time pursuant to Georgia law. And one of the students called up my office and said, I can't believe you bill in 6-minute increments, you know, a tenth of an hour. And the answer was, yes, we're lawyers. You bill tenths of the hour. So I think it's really important. We did pass the rewrite. I spent a lot of time with Sean, who will be here shortly, a lot of time with Holly. At first they thought I was crazy. At first the legislature thought I was crazy, because the fear of changing the sunshine laws is that the legislature will weaken them rather than strengthen them. And at the very end of the process, which took me 2 years, we were in a meeting with Tom Clyde, who's at least one of the lawyers, if not the main lawyer for the HAC, and we were at a hearing of the House Judiciary Committee, and Sean was there too, and he wanted, I think, 4 or 5 changes to make them happy with the bill. And the chair of that committee, Wendell Willard, gave him either 3 out of 4 or 4 out of 5, and he left that hearing giddy. What happened? He actually succeeded. They did what was desired. And then in the Senate, thankfully, no amendments. It just cleared the Senate. Actually, no votes in the Senate. 1 no vote in the House. And a lot of it was literally to make it more user-friendly. It really is 3 days. And if you can't do it in 3 days, you need to say within 3 days when you can do it. Make it easier to get stuff over the internet. You don't have to use paper nowadays. That you can have someone designated for an agenda item to receive all the requests, to make it user-friendly. But I'll tell you the same thing that I told Sean, that I told numerous folks. No one believed me, but it's the truth. The press pays 90% of attention to documents. They pay 10% attention to meetings. There is that other thing called the Open Meetings Act. When you attend a meeting and it's over in 20 minutes, but the book's this thick, you missed the right meeting. So for instance, in Cobb, Lisa, you'll tell me if it's still the same now, Monday morning before the Tuesday meeting, there's a work session where they go over each section of the agenda. And if any commissioners have questions, they ask the staff. That's the real meeting. That's what commissioners will say, I really don't like the way this is worded, it needs to be revised. And then between then and Tuesday, they'll work on an amendment for the meeting. Seldom did any members of the press go to that Monday morning work session. Do they come now?
One was there today, but it's infrequent.
Okay, so that's the real meeting, because that's when the work's done, last minute questions with the elected officials. I don't know if Fayette does it the same way or not. I know when I was chair of Cobb, I once showed up to a Smyrna City Council meeting, and beforehand they had me go to the work session. There was never press. So it was the Wild West, because the press is there to be that safeguard at that point. So I would just restate Justice Meltner's famous quote in Georgia law, which is the public official's quote must conduct the public's business out in the open. And that's really, really important. I mean, we have a lot of talk nowadays about the press. And that's a healthy discussion. I don't view that as a negative. That's a healthy discussion. But at the end of the day, if the press isn't public, if the press isn't active, then we really don't have a good democracy. And we really don't have a vibrant system of government. So it was always my pleasure. Now this guy, every time I'd go to Valdosta, I'd meet with him. And he would always tell me things that my office needed to do better. But that's once again positive. Because the only way you can improve is through that discussion. So having members of the press say, you need to do this, you need to do that, I always viewed that as a positive. You can always improve. No one is perfect. No one's close to perfect. Just ask my wife. So I used to really enjoy those meetings with Jim back then. And it's important. You didn't know that I knew that about the old hospital system as much
you
as
know,
I
you know a lot more.
And they had a lot of shenanigans going on in their hospital system down there, which is a shame. And I knew about it, but the law didn't frankly help me in several of those areas. So it's a pleasure to be here. I look forward to everyone enjoying tonight. I said nice things about you, Sean.
You did.
Talked about that House Judiciary meeting with Tom Clyde and you to get those last changes in 397.
Yes.
The codes. I mean, I spent a lot of time. Last thing I'll say. So we're done. We passed the bill. Everyone's happy. It counts. And I go up to Sean and I said, I've spent a lot of time with you, right? And she said, yes. And I said, so I have a favor to ask of you. And she got pretty white. And I said, I want a print of Mike Lukovich's drawing on 9/12, the day after 9/11, where you look in the Statue of Liberty's eyes and you see the Twin Towers and you see the tears. I thought Lukovich was brilliant. That was an amazing depiction. And she said, that's what you want. I said, I'm never going to sell it. I'm not looking. It's in my office. You go to my office, it's right there. But they still didn't trust me. So it says, to Sam, from Mike Lukovich. But I was never going to sell it. I just thought, you know, some political...
It's worth a lot more when it's signed, even if you didn't.
Well, the point of the matter is, you know, you look at them every day, and these folks are brilliant to do that work. But some days you sit there and say, oh my God, they just superseded any expectations, which I thought Mike did that day after 9/11. We actually had a commission meeting 9/11. I know where I was that day. So it's my pleasure. I look forward to y'all having a great program. I was at Nydia's infamous arrest As Nydia would tell you, I was the only elected official who actually defended her. Because you don't arrest the press for videoing a group gathering.
And thank you.
That's just a fact. You don't do it. That wasn't appropriate. And I'm sure I'm going to see this as it gets closer to her trial. Thank you very, very much. Thank you.